Hello everyone, welcome to brand new episode of The Hustle Today. I have another guest for you today. This guy is from batch 6. He's in his early 20s, and when he got into digital marketing through the Digital Deepak internship program, he was just a graduate and he was looking for career opportunities for himself. But somehow, with all the knowledge that he got from the program and then trying and testing and everything, right now he's a digital freelancer and consultant who helps small businesses grow their businesses. Now, the interesting thing about him is that at such a young age, just after completing his graduation, he's not worked with one client, he's worked with more than two, not even 18 clients. As a digital freelancer and a consultant, he has worked with 18 clients. That is so interesting at such a young age, right out of the program. So without further ado, let's just get him on the call and get to know the secrets as to how he did what he did. Hello, Hussain. How are you?
I am fine, sir. How are you doing?
Wonderful. So how's everything going?
Amazing. Everything is going just amazing and rocking.
I mean, of course, 18 freelance clients as a, 18 clients as a digital freelancer, like, of course it will be amazing. I mean, what's the secret, man? How did you do 18 clients? I think it's been 1 year, right?
Yeah, it's been it's been eight to nine months. If I count after DDIP.
18 clients, and you're in your early 20s. You just completed your graduation when you got into digital marketing. Like, okay, tell me, let's start from the beginning. What were you doing before the program?
So I started the basic short story. My name is Hussain Bora, son of a hardworking businessman and a supportive homemaker, an engineer turned digital marketer, and now helping small businesses to grow their business online.
Awesome. Great introduction.
Thank you, sir. So in the starting before DDIP, I had just completed my engineering. Mm-hmm. And it was like in the time of Corona. So what happened was that I just got my job, but I didn't got the joining letter because of Corona. Okay. So what happened was I was stuck on to what to do next, because six months have been gone after that. And there was nothing, neither the call from the company nor anything from the officials from their side. So before this, I was just, I had just noticed digital marketing as a boom. Mm-hmm. So I was also of the thought to try it. Not like to take it as a career, but just to how it is, how it works and how it can help me. Mm-hmm. So I came into this, and while one day I was searching on the internet and I got to Didi's 25 day video. And from there, I started my journey. So basically, my hobby was like, I love to talk about aeroplanes and this aeronautics things. So what I did was I just came inside. I just learned about how to build a website, how to optimize it and everything. And I just created a small blog in which I was writing about aeroplanes. And that time I didn't know that I also want a market to make this thing, to make me earn money. So then following DD's mails, DD's webinars, everything, one day I got to know about DD's internship. And I was really not thinking of losing this. But what happened was the fifth batch, I lost the access. I didn't got the link or something happened. But I was of the thought that on the next batch, I have to go. Mm-hmm. And in the next batch, I enrolled. And the journey in DDIP was just amazing. Like from first day of the success mindset, to the last day till we made our particular niche, that what we have to go to take it forward and how we can set career in that. Mm-hmm. So each and every point, there was something new, something learning and something amazing. And again, mentorship of DD, mentorship of you, sir, both were again amazing. And this helped me to reach to this level. Now, after DDIP, well, I think I was in week 7 when I got mine.
Let me pause you. Yes, out of all the assignments, which assignment was your favorite?
My favorite was understanding the niches, how which yeah. niche will help me to grow week. My business or grow week. My career.
Week three. Okay.
Week three. Yes, sir.
What was something that really that you enjoyed apart from that? You said that finding your niche, but like, why did you find it interesting? Why do you think it is important?
Sir, as Didi taught us, there are three things to take it into a niche. First is passion, second is your hobby, and third is market. So when these three, I found out that these three is inside that helping small scale businesses to grow their business. So well, while I was in my daily routine, I found my father, who was a real estate agent. He was struggling at that time. Secondly, my grand uncle, who is in Kuwait, he has a shop there of perfumes. So at that time of Corona, his market also went down. So these two things made me sort of to how to help them. And I came up with an idea of helping them first and then moving it forward to other people outside my home. And from this, I started my work. So you're not audible.
So, I mean, you found the real life case scenario on how you can, you know, apply the principles of digital marketing. Very interesting. Which assignment did you find the most challenging?
The last week 12. Okay. I think week 11 and 12, one of those was to call to a car, a big car showroom and to talk with them. So what I did was I talked to them and I became my own PA and I talked to them and I talked with that I am PA of Hussain Gora and this is what I need.
It's so interesting, man. So interesting.
And why I did this, because I felt that if I am a big personality who's going to buy this thing, so I should talk like them. But a PA can talk in some way which is not fit and which is not okay. So that can work for them. But if I will talk like this, they can judge me that Hussain Gora is not that big and like something like that.
Very interesting, man. Very smart. I love it. Okay. So how did you get the idea of trying digital freelancing? And I mean, how did you start it? How did you get
I was in week 7. I got on Facebook jobs and I just tried that how many people are searching for WordPress developers. Okay. Because at that time I knew WordPress website, how to develop it, and I can build a website which is okay, which can work fine. Mm-hmm. So I went there and I saw 4 to 5 people asking for it. I clicked on all, gave my resume to them and I submitted. Two of them called me back. And okay. One of them came to me and he was from my city only. So he asked me to let's meet and then we can talk on it. So I went there and I talked with him. And at that time, he also understood that I am a newcomer and he was also just starting his business.
Okay.
So from that point of view, from that time, I started my journey of freelance.
Awesome. Very interesting. I mean, so cool that you took the step online, but even if it required you to step offline, you didn't hesitate. That is so awesome.
So this was what I learned from digital marketing, because I was not a person who can meet anyone and who can talk like normal in normal way. So this is what mainly digital marketing and the success mindset had taught me.
I mean, everybody talks about that one video, week one video success mindset. It is indeed awesome. When you said that that is what you learned from digital marketing, I don't know, but you can let me know if my understanding is correct. So you probably meant that digital marketing is all about marketing first and digital second. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. Marketing yourself first. I believe that.
No, I mean, it is marketing in the first place. It is marketing.
In the first place. Medium, right.
So you understood the principles. Okay. Now that you are a digital freelancer, I think you have worked with 18 clients. I mean, that is a big number. What is the number one mistake that you, according to you, that small businesses make at this moment, in this current scenario, what is the biggest mistake that these small businesses, most of the small businesses are making, according to you?
First thing the small businesses are making is thinking of getting themselves get better first at like going to people and to make them understand that they are connected with them. They are doing directly what they are coming and they want sell. They want directly revenue.
Without building the relationship.
Which was the first, without building the relationship, without making people trust on them, they directly started selling and they directly wanted commissions. Like there was a client, what happened was in the first 15 days, just his ad was running and he asked me that there is no sale right now. And I told him that your ad is of not of a product, your ad is of making trust on people. But then also he was asking like, no, I won't sell first. And I, as when I was in DDIP, I learned that CAT formula, content, attraction, trust, transaction. So I was on the part of building trust. Content and attraction was done through ads, but trust was building. And he wanted that to get transaction first. And after 2 months, when he was getting a big amount of transactions, then he was satisfied.
That is, that is very true. It happens with a lot of businesses that they get into digital marketing that they think is just like magic, that you just come here, you run ads and you'll get the sales, as if there is some computer who is buying your buying your products or your
buying something.
That is so right. Okay. You are an inspiration, Hossein, for the young freelancers or young entrepreneurs who want to be a digital freelancer and who want to get clients. Right out of college, everybody wants to make some side cash and some side hustle. What is your advice to somebody who is in your shoes or roughly your age and who wants to get started? What advice would you like to give them? One, two, or three points, if you can give
them. 3 points, learn, do, teach. First, learn the skill, then do it and practice it, that how it is better and can get better on it, and then teach people. Because why, when you teach someone, you will get that skill more better. And if someone is asking you some question on that skill, and if you don't know, you will find out the answer, and then you will get that to answer them, and in this way you will become more better in that skill.
Very true.
So this is a small point: learn, do, and teach.
Very powerful concept that you have reiterated, and I think it is very true, because it's like rehearsal of what you have learned. Teaching is just a rehearsal of what you have learned, and it's also kind of a test that whether you have what you have learned is something that you have actually learned or just mugged it up. So true. Okay, so overall, if you just look back, what was the best part, or how was your experience in the program?
So the best part was the community. There was a lot of support from the community, with the mentors also and without the mentors also. They were like, when you put a question on them, there were people who are eager to answer their questions. And they are like, or who don't know, they are going to somewhere and they are finding out the answers by themselves. This was one thing. And the second thing I loved about DDIPs, they created an environment. It was a virtual environment, but it was an environment where we were attached to a learning because of the simple thing, cashback. And those cashbacks made us learn those things and to apply those also through the assignments. Was my also learning, that how you can make someone attached to a thing and to make it valuable. Like, we can also do this in businesses, that someone who does very good, they provide bonuses. Same DD did with the cashback thing which he brought in the DDIP.
Very important point, that, I mean, when somebody is serious, only then they'll get the results. I mean, the nutshell, at the core of it. That is how DDIP is. It kind of forces you to stay committed, because you have the fear of losing money, so you're serious, and only then you apply it and then you get the results. Very true.
And so people say that when you buy something for free, you don't value it. But I have seen that when people buy something for giving some money, then they also don't value it because they think that it is with us. We can do it whenever we are free and they can never be free for that.
Yeah. I mean, it's the fear of losing that drives people more than the fear of or the anticipation of a gain. Very important point. Now, Hussein, overall, looking back, did you ever think that, like before joining DDIP, that you would complete digital marketing, you would learn how to apply it for your father's business, for your uncle's business, and work for 18 clients and generate some good amount of revenue for yourself? Did it ever cross your mind? What do you think about it now, looking back?
So when I was starting the DDIP, I thought that it will just help me to create some extra income, which I thought that I could get some extra income, like from doing affiliate marketing or something small part. Okay. But now I believe that if DDIP wouldn't have come in my life, I won't be at this stage right now.
So nice. So humbling and so happiness. It's such happiness moment for us when, I mean, people like you say these kind of things. I mean, it's touching. It's awesome. And thanks to DD, I think, for giving us that opportunity. I have been in your shoes. And what you're saying is something that I can relate to. Wow. Thank you so much.
This was a journey which I would remember it for my life till I die. Like, this was something which made me believe on myself than anything else.
Awesome, Hussein. You are a very smart guy. I mean, at 23 years old, I mean, what to say? You have achieved a wonderful amount of, you know, gain in your career and the knowledge. And I mean, you are, of course, very intelligent. I have seen that since batch 6. And what you have been doing is phenomenal. And I wish you all the best for the future. Not just 1800 clients in the next 10 years. I mean, run an agency, build an agency, run it, hire more freelancers like yourself, inspire other freelancers, start an agency, help more companies, help your client generate revenue in billions. I'm sure you can.
I'm trying my best and I will do. Every step when I'm with my client, my every step is to explain them to how can I help them. At the first place, I never talk about what money is it will take for you, sir. I always talk about that, sir. How can I help you? Tell me about that. What are the issues you are facing first? And I think this particular belief had made me reach today till here, and I believe that will take me more forward.
Awesome. Thank you, Hussein, for your time. Thank you so much for being a part of the program, and thank you for the kind words. I wish you all the best, and I hopefully will get to interview you very soon.
Thank you, sir. And thanks to DD, and thanks to you very much for this lovely internship, lovely support, and lovely mentoring.
And thanks to you for the trust and completing all the assignments, applying them, and achieving and becoming a success story. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.